I am in fact joined by one more guest, Mr. Umar Shariff, who is a religious thinker. Many thanks for joining us on this broadcast, first of all. And you know, I'll start discussion with you. If you could tell us who is Siddaganga Mutt and how was he? Just make it very simple for all of us, because we have known so many things about Siddaganga Mutt. So if you could just, you know, explain in a very simple way, how was he?
Sri Shivakumara Swamy ji was highly respected by all the communities, especially in Karnataka and across India, and he is an international figure. And it is my honor and privilege to be talking about him, for he being such a wonderful person in terms of contributing in the field of education. In the field of education, he has contributed in immense manner, to the extent that thousands of people have benefited from his, you know, endeavor. And I also saw one clipping where little children, they were crying and mourning.
Absolutely.
And they were feeling the loss of a person, because he was talking to the need of the common man. And he is given the doctorate in literature. So he was a reader and learner and a spiritual guru. So we would say he is also respected by the Muslim community as well. So much so that yesterday one delegation from Bangalore also, they went all the way to meet
several occasions, you know, we have seen several of the Muslims who were performing namaz and praying for the speedy recovery of Siddaganga Mutt. But I'd really like you to comment on this. But before we proceed, we also have Pandit Aradhya. Mr. Umar Shariff, there you have it, Prime Minister Modi, you know, mentioning about Siddaganga Mutt, and also perhaps, you know, saying what the other 130 million people as of now would be, you know, stating across, I'm just talking about the mass population in India, that yes, he was the person who was for the masses.
Right. Yeah, he was a person who was not controversial of any kind.
At all. That is exactly what we were discussing.
Yeah, he did not get into the mainstream politics or anything. And he was welcoming anybody, whoever is coming to his ashram. And he was cooperative and supportive. So that way he has been the man whom people look up to. And at the same time, I would like to express my thoughts with respect to a person. See, a person from any community, whenever he is dead, as far as I coming from a Muslim background, I look back to what the Prophet taught us. Prophet, peace be upon him. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. A dead body of Yahud, yani from the Jewish community, was passing by, and the Prophet ﷺ stood up to show that respect. And the companions around, they were like wondering, I mean, it's the dead body of a Jew. What? I mean, why are you standing up? You know, that kind of a mindset.
Right.
So that point, the Prophet said, Alaysat nafsan, isn't this the soul? This is also the soul which is created by God Almighty. So as human beings, we respect all of them on this planet as the creation of God, and as someone who has the value of, you know, the integrity of having that soul in him. So that soul has to be honored, irrespective of which community it is coming from. So therefore, we have respect for him on that note.
He was one person who basically embarrassed all the religions. He really embraced all the religions. And he really did not say, all right, you're from Hindu background, you're from Muslim, or all right, you're a Sikh, so I'm going to be partial towards all three of you.
That is never to be done by any guru or any maulvi or any pastor or priest. Because a person follows a dharma, he follows a theology, but his deeds are immaterial. It's not looking into any human, or it doesn't look about any animal. It's about to everyone. He's like a light. Anybody who's spiritual is like a light. I mean, if he's moving around, the light doesn't go and say, like, I'm going to show it to the wall, I'm going to show it to this ground. It is showing to everyone, right? So similarly, every spiritual person, when he's applying his law or the theology on himself, that is for his own self. But when he's moving around, his actions are going to be for everyone. So that is the essence of any spiritual person, and for that we respect him.
Absolutely. Umar, coming to you, you know, how do you see this? You know, a sea of, you know, they've been there since yesterday.
Right.
Before we proceed to my previous question, but you know, they're like, they've been there since yesterday afternoon. They're refusing to budge, fighting everything, you know, fighting perhaps hunger, fighting, fighting cold, fighting heat. They're just there. They're just standing. This was the love that this person has earned, and this was the charisma that he used to carry himself with himself, isn't it?
Right. I agree. He has won a lot of hearts, which we cannot deny, and a lot of people are paying their last tribute. And irrespective of religion, irrespective of political parties, we see a lot of people across the world who are expressing their feelings and their condolences. So that is evident as of here. As for I, coming from a background of a practitioner of Islam.
And also, yeah. Umar, I'm sorry I'm cutting you in between, but yes. Malicious. We were just discussing this when we started the discussion that, you know, we also showed the visuals of a few Muslims earlier, okay. Of course, a few days ago. Literally, they were performing namaz, they were, you know, and praying for the recovery of Siddaganga's here.
Right. That's so good. See, the thing is...
Absolutely no religious bounds over here.
See, absolutely no. You'll be amazed. You'll be amazed, actually, because I'm coming from Indore. We had a program there. And there, I made supplication for two members who are not feeling well. And many of them might be wondering, what's it? I made supplication for Amit Shah ji and for Arun Jaitley ji. I said, like, let them get cured. See, the point is not that. As a human, I made this supplication.
Why do you think that people will be surprised?
The people are surprised because, like, a Muslim and the BJP are always portrayed as, you know, always portrayed. I'm not saying they are.
We have many Muslims as our union ministers. I know. I don't think so. I think this is.
Always portrayed by some of them saying that Muslims and BJP members are at two ends. I would say we must look beyond parties. We must look at human as a human, and that spirit will take us very far. And that is one of the ingredients of this India that we are living in, wherein we have the sense of belongingness to each other. We sense of relation that we are from this country. We are this, people of this country. We have our common ancestors and common origin. And we have worked to achieve this status. So that way, this has to continue. But there are, you know, differences. Like, for instance, we made supplication to God Almighty. And we respect this man. The difference is that
everyone respects.
The thing is, which is really making the difference, is that we make supplication to the one in the heavens, and at the same time, we hope good for the people on the earth.
I'll come to you 1 minute.
As the Prophet taught us, peace be upon him, he said, "Irhamu man fil ard, yarhamukum man fis sama." The meaning of it is, show mercy to the people on the earth, or not only people. Man means to everyone on this earth, so that the one in the heavens will show mercy unto you. So if we want to earn, if you want to be earning the love of God, then you have to share the love that you have with the creations of God. So that's a way to reach up to Him by the spiritual, enlightenment. That anybody wants to achieve that status of getting the mercy of God Almighty, he or she, irrespective of where she is coming from or where he is coming from, he has to be merciful unto the creations. That is the essence that I would want to share. Yes, we do have our own theological differences, like the for mentioning God as a, you know, to the Swamiji, we see him as a human being. And as saying seer, the word seer itself means prophecy, the one who is going to profess about the future. Now we see again him as a human being. The word seer, when we say, it is for the prophets who are given divine revelations. So there lies the theological differences. But when we are able to look at him and present our condolences and our spirit of love and our spirit of belongingness to this country and for his service as an educationist, what is more appealing to me is that the little children, they were feeling the part of,
the parting away of the... Yeah, we showed the visuals of the same, they were crying and...
So that is the real thing that really moves me. I think that's what I take from him. What I'm taking from this great educationist is that he earned, he was a, what was it, Padma Bhushan.
Padma Bhushan
and doctorate for literature.
Yes.
That is amazing.
All right.
He earned it.
All right.